What is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode here on Above Average. Obviously, if you're new to the channel, my name is Trevor, and we're doing things a little bit different today. I haven't set up my room quite yet, but we're going to do this. We're doing things the old way, and that's okay. There's nothing wrong with that, but there's a lot to talk about. I was kind of blown away when I look at my phone this morning. I seen Zdeno Chara. Well, first I seen Keith Yandle. Obviously, he retired last night, and he said it on Spit and Chicklets podcast. So that was kind of insane. And then obviously Zdeno Chara, he retires, and then PK Subban, he follows suit. So we're going to be talking about Keith Yandle first, and then Zdeno Chara, and then obviously we'll talk about PK Subban at the end. So if you just came here for that, that'll be at the end of the video. Without further ado, let's just get this thing going. Yeah, so this is insane. You see that I put end of an era. It's an end of an era for a reason. Keith Yandle, he was, you know, one of, if not the funniest. He was talked about for his humor. Obviously, he was a pretty funny guy, but this guy put up really, really good numbers for a long time. And even though he wasn't as flashy, you know, he was still a really, really good player, playing for the Phoenix Coyotes, Arizona Coyotes, whatever you want to call them, the New York Rangers, Florida Panthers, and then the Philadelphia Flyers to finish, you know, what was a really successful career, 1,100 games, pretty well, just over that. And, you know, he's an active Ironman streak holder. Good for you. That's probably going to be broken this year by Phil the Thrill. But, you know, what an unbelievable career by Keith Yandle. You're looking at some of his numbers, and, you know, I'll show these. But, man, you just a very, very quiet, very, very underrated defenseman. He wasn't flashy, but, man, he still put up really, really good numbers. 62 points just a few years ago for the Florida Panthers. I mean, that's really respectable in today's day and age, especially as a defenseman, and especially for how old he was to do that. You know, it's honestly, it takes a lot of talent. So it's pretty impressive. Keith Yandle, what a beauty. Obviously, this last season wasn't his best, and I think he kind of noticed that. He was like, okay, I should probably hang him up. I was more of a liability out there than I was helping my team out, and I think that's kind of what it came down to. But Keith Yandle, like, just what a great guy, what a great career, and nothing best to you. Obviously, the big one, Zdeno Chara, one of the big ones. This man, this guy, how many records? I mean, one of the toughest, if not the toughest guy to ever play in the NHL. I never seen this guy actually struggle in a fight. He kind of just toyed with every opponent he ever fought, and which is insane. You know, he fought the toughest of the toughest guys, Ryan Reeves, you know, the Milan. No, I don't think him and Luch ever fought, but you get what I'm getting at. Drafted by the New York Islanders way back, and this is insane. 25-year career. That's older than me. This guy was in the NHL longer than I've been in this world, so that is kind of insane. You know, you look at the games played. It's insane. 1,680 games played. He was able to rack up 680 points in those 25 seasons, 1,600 games and 80 games played. So pretty respectable. You know, obviously the last few years of his career weren't the greatest offensive numbers, but, you know, peak Chara, he was one of the best defensemen of this generation, of my generation growing up. He definitely was up there for sure. What a shot. I mean, this guy really, you know, I always think he wasn't really the man for the job. I don't think he should have. You know, I always like Patrice Bergeron. I think he should have held the captaincy. But, you know, this guy still was a really, really good leader for that team for so long, and he did so much. He was a minute muncher, and it was incredible. I mean, this guy just, it's insane. The fact that he's retiring at 45 years old, like 45, he's almost 50, and he's playing with kids that are 18. It's insane. What a monster shot, this guy. You know, he was pretty good defensively too, and yeah, he will be missed. He's this is a one in, I don't think there's ever going to be a player like Zdeno Chara to, you know, ever step foot in the NHL again. He's just so versatile, you know, everything you kind of want in a defenseman, for a defensive defenseman. But he was prioritized defensively, but he was still able to rack up, you know, 50 points in his prime, and consistently, you know, right around the 50-40 point mark, and that is insane. His shot was lethal and will be terrorizing goalies for, you know, in their nightmares for, I'm sure, a long, long time to come. The Weber and Chara slap shot competitions that they'd have every single year was just honestly one of my favorite things to watch in the All-Star game growing up. It was insane, and it was kind of, you know, even the players really liked it. It was really cool to watch, and, you know, hardest slap shot, well, I guess, no, that Furt guy. broke his slap shot record a few years back, but still one of the hardest shots in NHL history. It is insane. Zdeno Chara, he's definitely, I think, a Hall of Famer for sure. You know, you look at the cups that he's won, the amount of time that he's played. Yeah, this guy is definitely going to go into the Hall of Fame, I think, eventually down the road. I don't know if he's first ballot Hall of Famer, but I'd like to see that for sure. He deserves it. Anytime you spend 25 years in the NHL dedicating, you know, a quarter of your life for an organization, I'm sure that goes a long way. So, Zdeno Chara, congratulations. You deserve this, man. What an unbelievable career you had. And last but not least, the big one, the one that surprised so many of us, PK Subban. What the hell? This is honestly blew my mind. I really don't know why. Like, I wonder if it's if no one really wanted him, and if that's why he didn't sign, and he was like, nah, if no one really wants me, then I'm gonna retire. Because, you know, if that is the case, that's kind of sad. But, you know, you look at what he's been able to do the last few years. I know this last year was, I guess his first year with the Devils was his worst year. If you're going by points, 18 points, 68 games. This year he had 22 points in 77 games. But, I mean, people forget Prime Subban was just electric and so much fun to watch. I remember the first time watching him in the 2009 World Juniors, him and John Tavares, lighting it up, and they won gold against Sweden. I remember seeing Subban and just hearing him, and it was all I heard pretty well, him and John Tavares. I knew that he was going to be a player, and it was just so nice to see him just flourish in Montreal for all those years. What he was able to do for the community, it was really just amazing. And he was a focal point for that city for so long. Him and Price, their bromance was kind of legit. And people forget, like, Prime Subban was like a legit number one defenseman, you know, contending Erik Karlsson for best defense, well, and a few others, but he was insane. And that's a video I'll kind of dive into in another time. But yeah, Subban, he was a beast. He was electric, flashy. He could throw his weight around. He had nice hands, good shot. He was literally, he was literally so good. Sometimes he was a little bit of a liability, and obviously there's the drama and the attention that he brings, himself and to his team. And not a lot of people like that, but, you know, at the end of the day, he's still a beauty. He's still going to go down as one of the greatest, most likable, marketable players in NHL history. This guy, you know, just, he loves the attention. And whether you like it, whether you don't, if you're an old timer back at home just thinking you don't like it, well, that's okay. Because, it is okay. He showed his personality, and not a lot of people, we kind of were missing that. Who else was showing their personality at the time? Him and Ovechkin, that was pretty well it. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I think Subban was just an unbelievable talent, and, we're talking about Zdeno Chara's 25-year career. I think Subban's wasn't even half that, so it's kind of crazy to think, Subban, unbelievable career. This guy deserves, he deserves a time off. All these players have worked very hard that I've talked about in this video, and, they deserve a little break. So, Subban, obviously, it's an end of an era, which is why I take that in the thumbnail. It's sad, because, next up, it's Ovechkin, next up, it's Crosby, and, it's tough to see players like these start retiring. But, that's just a hockey fan in me. Obviously, they deserve it. They've worked very hard. And, Subban, if you ever watch this, congrats, buddy. What a hell of a career. You should be very proud. And it was an honor watching you play all those years. It was so fun. And, if you guys would like me to make a pump-up video or something like that on the prime years of PK Subban, definitely let me know in the comment section below. But that pretty well wraps up this video, guys. Just kind of wanted to talk about those three players. This is kind of insane. I had no idea. It's like retirement day. This is kind of weird. I don't know if I've ever had like three pretty, star players retire in the same day. It doesn't really happen often, but hell of a career for all three of them. And wish them nothing but the best. But if you're new to the channel, as always, feel free to leave a like and subscribe. And hopefully in the next video you can actually see my beautiful face, and I'll have everything set up. So until then, guys, I'll see you, and take her easy, and bye, peace.
Subban.